I strongly feel that like we have moved from information scarcity to information overload.
Yes.
So as an end user, even though people resort to selective reading, there is way too much of content to assimilate. So you as an end user, what is your take on that?
Well, nowadays the technology enables you to pick up, select what you want to, information you want to take. So that is one way to do it. I mean, there are websites, there are apps which are available that you punch the subjects which you are interested in, and you will get news only on those subjects. And soon you will see, even in mass media, what is going to happen is that the connected TV at your home, and you don't have to watch all the news, whatever is being shown at whatever time. There will not be any prime time. So you watch whichever news you want to watch at whatever time you want to watch. That's coming soon. So there may be over information which is available. And information, we believe that whatever is written on Google is the truth. It is not. I mean, my granddaughter was one day, she came to me and she said that I have to write an essay on Lokmanya Tilak. Bal Gangadhar Tilak or Lokmanya Tilak, whatever name you call it. So I gave her some information, whatever I knew. I said, beta, baki main information aapko koi ek do phone karke leke deta hoon. But then after half an hour she comes, said, nahi nahi dada, maine dekh liya, Google pe dekh liya. Kya dekha? He was a militant Hindu leader. Can you believe that Lokmanya Tilak was a militant? I don't think so. So, I mean, this is where many of our reporters and journalists go wrong. Mehnat nahi karte hain. Google pe dekh liya, kuch pad liya, khabar laga diya wahan. That is also one source that we lose our credibility.
Though we are discussing about news media losing its credibility, I would like to put forward a different viewpoint of this. If we see that nowadays news channel like to put forward the news in a very descriptive manner, like they would like to get more information about every single topic rather than the days before, and they would like to give the news much at a very earlier time than other competitors. So they would like to put forward the news first on their channel. So what is the benefit that people are getting is that they're getting a better information about every topic, and they're getting the news much faster than the earlier days.
Yeah, both things are happening, but many times in anxiety to give the news in advance from others, sometimes they make mistake also. But certainly that is the positive of our news media in India, that today, I mean, there is a fear in the minds of the legislature, the executives, even to some extent in the courts, that when something comes on the media, whether it is on social media, mass media, print, electronics, they are careful. They don't take things for granted as they used to. I remember 1970s, if somebody remembers, there was a famous Nagarwala murder case in Delhi. This gentleman was murdered in Delhi in daylight robbery. One day only some news came in the newspaper, next day onwards blacked out. Nobody talked about it, why he was murdered and who murdered him. You see, case as an example, we have just celebrated 40th year on 25th of June, emergency. The government could censor the newspapers at that time conveniently. It's a different thing that they lost the election because of the censoring of the news. They didn't know what's really happening on the ground. That resulted into loss of election. But they could censor. Can they, any government censor today? Even if they apply emergency rules, I don't think so. There's so much happening, so many social media, print media, TV stations, so many of them, that nobody can censor today. It's impossible.
But I find in China, media is completely censored. You can't access Facebook, you can't
access... But that is different, sir. That country is not a democratic country.
Well, that's fine. But even here, we can do that. If the government wants to do it, they can do it.
No, sir. In a democracy, you cannot do it. People will... I mean, this is a whole new subject altogether.
Okay.
I will tend to disagree, sir.
Right, sir.
Because it's a whole new subject. I mean, I would say that we have got political freedom in this country, but we have not got social and economic freedom, even today after 70 years of our existence. And political freedom, or mean democracy, or whatever you call it, today it is impossible. They tried to. UPA too, I mean, we heard 3-4 days it was a news in the media when they said that we are going to stop this social media, we're going to censor, we did this. But there was so much hue and cry that they had to back off second, third day. Today it's not possible. I mean, we are seeing these days so many actions being taken in a hurry by the executives or political legislative people, and you see all of a sudden 4 days, 5 days, they withdraw that. I mean, recent case of how do you file your income tax return? That income tax return form was almost 20 pages. They wanted you to fill up every single foreign trip of yours when you take up. Where did you go? How much money did you spend? All those stuff. And when you take up. Where did you go? How much money did you spend? All those stuff. And the social media went berserk. And they had to withdraw that form. So it's not easy, sir, today. China is continuing and they still have. All media is government controlled. And from day one, they put stop on internet. Everything is censored. We are the only Asian TV channel which is permitted or allowed. We have got license in China. But our entire programming goes through a check before it is put, though it is entertainment programming. And it is run about 6 minutes late, 5-6 minutes late. Their people are sitting in our retransmission center in China. They go through every single frame by frame.
Sir, as you said, government cannot censor currently the media because of the power of the media. But there have been unfortunate cases like suspicious deaths of journalists or even an IT technician or IT professional in Pune. Can we say that because of such events, out of fear, media is giving in its credibility and bending down to big guns?
No. One stray case doesn't deter the people.
I wanted to ask you, being the chairman of the SL Group, you're coming and speaking in the front of public for about the media credibility. It takes a courage. But what I wanted to ask is, what after this discussion? We just somebody talked about, what about the follow-up after the discussion? What more can be done to gain the credibility back? Is just about the discussing it, or what more can be done from the media side to gain the credibility back to it?
I believe that I am the change. I have to first change myself. I have to change. If I control a media, news media, I should change first. And I believe that if we change it towards this direction, what we have found out from people, ourselves, first time a media company's owner and the editors have gone out to talk to people one-to-one themselves. And we know where we are heading, what people want from us. So we will change. But on the other hand, I think you can also join me in that change. I'm going to certainly not leave this discussion here, just on the show, discuss the topic and go away. That's why I said we have formed a DSC club. We have 9 objectives. I have decided on that. 2 of them, we are leaving the local DSC club to decide. whatever is the need with the local requirement. Seven of them, I will show you what our objectives are. This is the major problem today youth of our country do face. Most of the youngsters are confused that what do we do? So those confusion are because people don't know what their true talents are. Because all of us are born with some or the other talent. Our parents can't understand what the talent of the child is. And I'm sorry to say, I'm sitting in the Mecca of education, but even our teachers have not practiced it. I can tell spade a spade because I can put myself onto the same thing, and I accept my follies and I defend myself when I'm not there wrong. So same way, people are not able to find what their own talents are, and that's why there is a confusion. I've gone to other management institutions, engineering colleges, medical institutions. I ask them, kyun bhai, kyun aaye yahan? Somebody says, because my parents wanted me to do the management. Usme nokri achhi mil jati. Somebody says, no, my friends were going into management, so I also came. Someone says, main pehle engineering karne gaya tha, lekin maine suna ke engineering karne walon ke aajkal कोई पूछ नहीं है समाज में, इसलिए मैनेजमेंट में आ। तो मतलब ये हर्ड मेंटेलिटी है, यू आर डूइंग इट समथिंग विदाउट रियलाइजिंग व्हाट इज योर ओन टैलेंट एंड योर टैलेंट इज व्हाट योर रिपीटेड पैटर्न ऑफ बिहेवियर इज योर टैलेंट व्हाट डू यू लाइक टू डू द मोस्ट इज योर टैलेंट यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट एंड देन अकॉर्डिंगली सी where your talent fits of what kind of study and what kind of jobs, what kind of career. You will have no confusion. And without confusion, you reach to the greater heights. That's what at least I have practiced, and I am where I am because I never allowed myself to be confused. Even if there was confusion, take decision, go for it. So this is what first one would be the objective, to identify talent of the people through our DSC club members and guide people that what they should be doing. And then it's a big thing, second one, to set up a institution which I have registered already, Brain Trust of India is the name. You'll be surprised that 2.5-3 children out of every 1,000 children born in this country is a prodigy child. But because our parents, our society at large is not able to recognize that they are a prodigy child, they are treated like any other children. With the result, those people get frustrated. They become a burden on the society rather than becoming an asset on the society. Singapore, such a small, tiny country, equivalent to the one city of India, have got 3 institutions looking after the prodigy children. Third one is related to the second one, open the schools for these prodigy children, and then to college, and then uske baad even a special university for them. And fourth one is, again, a large, many a times I get this question, that I have an idea, but I don't have money. We do want to become bridge between the would-be entrepreneurs and make them job givers rather than job seekers. So that is our fourth one. Fifth one is...
Z24 Tas, Raha Ek Paul Pudhe.